Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play DDTank Mobile on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install DDTank Mobile and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play DDTank Mobile. So without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else buddies, to start we have to open our favorite web browser. We open the one we use by default. Let's continue, going to the current URL I'm highlighting in green. Now, you are able to see on the PC screen. There is no need to type that URL, because I provided the link in the description of this video and the first pinned comment. We ended up at this point on our own website of Usitility, where we include an in-depth demonstration on the way to download and install DDTank Mobile on PC. We search lower a tad and just click on the Download Game on PC button. Once clicking on this link, we arrive here on the website of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we are going to use to get access to this game DDTank Mobile on our PC. It is now obvious that we have several advantages of preferring using the emulator. So we are ready to start downloading the DDTank Mobile by clicking on the button play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green. We then click on it. Of course, the download step takes no time at all. Here it is, this is the download. It is a file to execute. The following step is to run the installer, okay, so we have to click on the file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to allow modifications to the computer. We have said yes. I minimize the internet browser to start to see the installer much better. The installation software is very simple. It is made up of two options, install and setup path. I will describe what setup path genuinely does. We purely simply click on it, and therefore we realize that we display here the path where the emulator will be placed. If we need to change for better this folder, we are required to click on the browse button. Therefore we select another folder and install the emulator wherever we want. To keep it simple, just set it where it is. Then I click on back. Therefore I just click install. Fantastic. The setup commences and it's going to proceed along with the download of those MB which are shown on the screen. The moment you download it, it might possibly be a little bit more or less MB. The download speed may go at a higher speed or at a lower speed, subject to your web access and according to the data transfer rate of the emulator web servers. Right away they're progressing super fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At present, the emulator happens to be started immediately. As you can discover, at the bottom of the screen, we have a progress bar that will fill up then when it actually reaches the ending, the emulator can be started for the first time. Indeed, the emulator has been started, here for the first time. Before we keep going, as you will notice, it created two icons right here on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks app icon will be only one we are interested in. At any time when we are planning to start DDTank Mobile on our desktop or laptop, we double-click on that app icon and consequently launch the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Shall we conduct the next phase, that is a must, and which is to begin browsing the Google Play Store. And we'll just click on Play Store. As you can view the Google Play is started. In this case we must sign in. So now once we're there, we must perform the next phase that is absolutely mandatory. So we click on Sign In. Presently it shows Checking Info. It might in some cases get stuck in checking info, additionally it doesn't continue. In this case, you may attempt to log in after a few hours and it may most certainly be sorted out. At this time we can type our username and password. The email needs to be a Gmail email as well as its associated password. For example, you can use the same exact email you're using right now in your own YouTube account. So I am going to submit my info and I'll come back after I have accomplished it. Voila! Info typed. And here is Google welcoming us and offering us their terms of service. We must consent to them all by clicking on, I agree. Following that, it makes us possible to backup to the Google Cloud. You could leave it selected and it'll generate a backup of your data on this device to Google Drive. I won't select it, you can utilize that feature if you prefer. We simply click on Accept. Google Play, formerly Android Market, is started without need to open it manually and immediately. To install the video game, we must get to the Android emulator desktop by simply clicking on this icon indicated in green. At present that we are discovering the desktop of that Android emulator, we see that we have now right here the install app game option. We then click on the button. Listed here we come with the Android game. Let's quickly click right here on the install option that I'm just showing now in green color. That click will launch the software setup. At present it will download on your desktop or laptop and set up the Android game. It normally takes a bit of time or it may be almost immediate. It all is subject on our connection to the internet. It has already ended setting up. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by clicking the following button that I am showing in green, to be able to use DDTank Mobile for the first time. You are currently on the emulator desktop, and then we are going to click that fresh DDTank Mobile app icon which was created. Your game app is started for the first time. There we get it, I'm able to mouse click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I have to discuss the sound level of this emulator. It is right here. We have got the icon of higher volume along with the icon of lower volume. This manner we don't depend on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound experience of the emulator. And also to take pleasure in the experience to the greatest, we could turn on the large monitor, for which we have two alternatives. This one is actually the very first one, we just click on this software icon that I'm showing in green color. Thus the monitor is maximized, enjoying one border at the top, one at the right and the third one at the bottom. Granted that we need to launch the video game in full screen, we select this particular software icon. And thus we would likely without a doubt be experiencing the game in 100% screen setting. To stop the 100% screen functionality, press the F11 key. And we just end up being in normal display mode. At present, I am on the way to clarify you the computer keyboard mapping which is definitely extremely cool. That step we will be able to play the game far more easily. The very first thing is to click on this software icon. It's now time to complete the required configurations. Let me keep the normal settings, though if you desire to change this, you can also do this without any problem. As you can observe, the emulator is fully in our own language. In some cases it happens that your emulator is started in the erroneous language, for instance, in Mandarin. And as a consequence to place it in the appropriate language we go here to the cogwheel. And thus there throughout additional settings, we mouse click on the language drop down. We may go with the language we wish, German, Chinese, etc. As soon as the language is chosen, we are going to save, the emulator would reboot, and the game, next time we start it, will also be in the picked language. So now, you can find another point that we will need to take into account, and it's that we will receive a message from Google reporting that a different device has been connected to this Google account. It should check with us if we are the people who have connected that device. Yup, we really should not be troubled, since the emulator is acting as in Google Android smartphone or tablet. So you can determine which tablet or smartphone is being emulated, we come right here, to the cogwheel and we simply click on it. Let's browse here to the model selection. And right here we see that the emulator is behaving like a Samsung mobile phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it guys, so much for my training. I hope you enjoyed it, particularly that everyone thought it was interesting. If so, give it a pleasant like, subscribe to my channel, and I will be happy to answer your remarks, questions or suggestions, put them in the comment area down below. You may also leave a remark on my Twitch channel, I actually do live streams on occasion, you get it listed below in the video description and in the initial pinned comment. Simply click on any of those instructional videos that happens to be appearing on the computer screen and see you in the following training videos. Bye.